And obviously the reverse side, so she'll be generating lots of different spins.
You know, Kasumi Ishikawa has beaten the best defender in the world on the women's side of the game, Wu Yang, three times, and beaten her badly in their last two encounters. So I think she's pretty well set against choppers in general. There are no shortage of katoman choppers in Japan. Quite a rich history of it, actually. Some of the most spectacular choppers I've seen. Actually, Masato Shiono's here working one of the booths with a brand.
But then Ukraine has produced an awful lot of defenders over the years.
Yeah, I feel like in Eastern Europe in general, we see a lot more in the women's game. A lot of choppers. This region, I mean, after all, they've got two in the lineup here. Second and third singles matches are choppers for Ukraine. Windshield wiper serve here. First point for Bielenko so far this match. It's interesting to see the variety of serves. You know, we talked about the shovel serve a lot that seems to be rising in popularity and usefulness out here, but having something a bit special and different can be quite effective as well. Now, what I always wondered is if you're twiddling that often, obviously like anything else, with time and practice, you get quite familiar with what's where. And, but in that second shot, she received with the inverted on the backhand first.
4-1.
Unless I have it backwards, maybe I need a closer look at what's on the racket. So it sounded, let me see that. Do you see inverted on the red? Tough to see so far. No, pips.
I think the red is the short, the long pimples.
Yeah, me too. So that means we had a lot of receives with the inverted rubber. Now, you used to do this quite a bit, right? Put the long pips on the forehand for chops?
Yeah, I used to play with long pimples mainly on the forehand, but I did twiddle as well and use them on the backhand. But then, you know, when you do twiddle like that, you've got to learn to play backhand with a long pimple and reverse and a forehand with long pimple and reverse, and they're totally different strokes. So there's a lot of strokes that you have to practice.
It's like learning a tonal language when you didn't grow up with one. It's just so much extra work to consider.
But I think most of the time when I did play, I played with short pimples and reverse. Not very often. I didn't play for a long period of time with long pimples.
There we had the floating push. A little bit less rotation. Ishikawa overlifting. Good placement here. Wider and wider. And she's got the long pips on the backhand side for most of this rally.
Yeah, she can control it more.
Good
with
variation.
The long pimples, and it is quite spinny, so there's going to be an awful lot of backspin going back, but she's playing into the body and then wide on the backhand. Being a lefty, she can get that good angle.
It's funny, that's a good point. I often say that in terms of control, in terms of controlling the spin, you know, you can't change the spin as easily with the long pips, but it is easier to control the shot unless you're attacking. With attacking, you need that extra spin. And Bielenko, she's quite an aggressive player in general. She can attack with the long pips, but like anybody else, it's just not easy to do. I think the more sponge you have, the longer it sits on the rubber and sinks in a little bit. We saw Linda Bergstrom playing pretty high percentage with the long pips attacking. Very focused Ishikawa. I mean, there was a loaded chop in there. I thought it would give some trouble, but she generates a lot of power on timing, gets good racket head speed there.
Yeah, it did pop up a little bit there. I think it was an easier ball for Ishikawa to attack. She's quite happy just to take her time. Slow spinny, and then when one comes up a little bit higher, she steps in.
Was called?
5-9.
It was the top of the net. I couldn't see if there was service warning. Oh, beautiful placement. Short side. Sits up a little high and confidently. Kasumi goes where, well, the forehand won't reach. I'm still curious about the serve before that windshield wiper serve. I know we go to tomahawk here. Just too much trouble. Ishikawa on top of the bounce, playing the wide corners, takes game number one with the Thortai. Bielenko will start with the serve. Jill and I were talking briefly about how long it's been since we've seen the windshield wiper serve.
Yeah, it's quite some time.
That used to be a classic back in the day, yeah?
It certainly did, and that's when you didn't have to throw the ball up, so you could, you know, put it straight on your bat, and they changed the rule.
Were you playing still after the rule change?
Which rule change?
About the height of the toss.
I stopped playing in 83.
Oh, so that angle is just too wide. Stopped playing in 83. Okay. Yeah, in 83, I also was not playing, so we were in the same boat.
You probably weren't even born then.
Well, that'd be a good reason not to be playing, right? It's pretty much the only excuse. Again, you know, as a left-handed player, you have an advantage in terms of angles. You'll see a lot of step around forehands, especially against the defender, because you have a little bit more time as defenders float the ball up and tend to be behind the table. Ishikawa's playing it with precision quite consistently. There we go, backhand loop. Think of all the shots we were talking before about when you have two different surfaces on your racket. How many different types of chop you have to learn, but then attack too. Bielenko's not afraid to attack with inverted rubber or long pips, forehand or backhand. It's like eight different things she has to practice very specifically.
Oh, that's a beauty. Absolute beauty, wasn't it, down the line?
I wanted to take a picture of it. I mean, how many times now? She's showing that she can play both corners. She can play inside out wide, short side of the table. Again, Bielenko's quite tall. She's got the wingspan to cover the corners. Perfect build for a defender.
I think she disguises it so well as she can when she plays it. You can't, it's at last minute. She just changes direction with a wrist.
I think you're right. That's a big part. Here it's just a steady point, but with these big shots that aren't getting touched, they're hit out of reach. She's so subtle. It's almost like magic. You know, we talked about being a magician with the wrist on the serve, but even in the rally, Kasumi Ishikawa is a quite complete player. Good variation here. The windshield wiper serve, which I actually learned in Japan, often has underspin, but can be contacted with a variety of spins. And pops up a third ball here. Bielenko gets the third ball she wants.
6-4. Can't afford to give away easy push strokes like that.
It's always interesting when you have a player who's got so many different weapons, like Tatiana Bielenko, what you choose to go with against a player who's so solid against choppers, against defense. Funny, I've seen Ishikawa testing out a bunch of different equipment over the last year. I feel like she's been playing very well recently.
Different types of rubber?
partially that, and I think blades.
Blades. Mm-hmm.
I think she's using Chinese rubber on the forehand last few times I've seen. But I did see her try out some different blades as well. And there have been a lot of switching. I think I've seen Ma Long's face on the bottom of more rackets this tournament than any tournament I've seen. And it looks like she's using one that Zhang Jiko made quite popular, the Viscaria. Another strong left-handed player, Hina Hayata, Guinness World Record holder with Mima Ito for doubles in Dusseldorf last year.
Lovely play there by Ishikawa. She's top spinning consistently and then just waiting for that right one. She steps in and hits it a bit harder.
Apology not accepted. Top of the net and super shallow on the table. I think both players thought the point was over. It's 5 game points for Ishikawa. Man, is she on point right now. 11-5 once again. Domination from Ishikawa. In control and one game away. World ranked number 3, Kasumi Ishikawa. I think this is her best world ranking currently, and she's playing the best table tennis in the last year or so that I've seen in her life. So well deserved, and she's starting off strong here.
She's very patient. She's quite prepared to put some spinny balls in. Just wait for the right one like that, and then get that great angle in as well.
So anyway, when I think about choppers, you know, I was thinking about the men's side of the game, Germany versus China, in theory, and if they would play a chopper, if they would play Filus or not, because China's so strong against choppers with shots like that. Third ball's finishing the point. And a break again. Ishikawa says, sorry, knowing that the player knew much more about the game than I did at the time, probably still. And the whole point was to just relax her and make her laugh. She said, just be funny with me. I said, sure. And she played an incredible match. We'll see. But Ishikawa, nothing phasing her yet, right down the middle of the table. Haven't even gotten past the third ball, and a handful of points, it feels like now.
Well, she's 2-0 up, and she hasn't lost a point in this third game, so she's going to just go for her shots.
Note to self, do not throw choppers into the Ishikawa furnace. Just thinking strategically, you know, team play, it's always so interesting to see what lineups come out. And obviously, it's a blind pick for both sides. Coaches don't know exactly what they're going to get on the other side, but have a general sense based on how strong the team is, the individual players. Jill, this score right here, I mean, it's so rare to see an exhibition point in women's table tennis. We've still got a ways to go before that, but this is the type of score that gets you thinking, what if? I don't imagine it from the fight we saw, especially having players to follow. You have to send a message for the third singles. We still have a chance.
Yeah, and to be fair, I mean, Ishikawa, she's played superb in this match. She hasn't really missed a lot at all. She's been very patient. Just waiting until one pops up slightly, then she hits it harder and gets a good angle. Let me see it again.
Jeez. I mean, just think about this for a sec. Defender's specialty is getting the ball back on the table. The average rally is significantly longer. Matches last longer against choppers. She's finishing on third ball every other point. And finally, a human moment. Had that shot come down and won the point, it would have been 10-0. Ishikawa clearing the table. letting one on the scoreboard. Longest rally in some time, and now it is 9 game and match points for Ishikawa to get another match for the Japanese women. Now, in terms of exhibition points, if there were to be one, it would have to be Bielenko who initiates it. For Ishikawa to suggest it would not be how this plays out. And there it is, 11-2. Absolutely smothering, silencing, handcuffing, and dominating Kasumi Ishikawa in top form. Takes out, in my opinion, the top player despite the world ranking. Very impressive play again from Ishikawa, world rank number 3, the 25-year-old team captain for Japan.